Juan, I am Cadet Gabito of VSMT2 Bravo, and today we will talk about our problem and I'll explain it to you.
So here's our problem. So it says that you swung a ship and compared the magnetic compass against the gyro compass to find deviation. So the gyro error is 2 degrees west, the deviation is 8 degrees west. So problem is find the deviation on true heading of 157. So what I've done here is I converted the true heading into a magnetic heading. So a true of 157 degrees plus the variation of 8 degrees west, we can get the magnetic of 165. So next is the PGC and PSC. So what I've done is I chose 144 and 152 PSC because 152 and 181 and the center is 165. So the next is 174 and 181. Next is 144 minus 2 degrees west gyro error. The true heading is 142. Oh, sorry. I mean the true is 142. Then plus variation of 8 degrees west, we can get of 150 magnetic. So 150 and 152, we can get the deviation of 2 degrees west. Same below. 174 minus 2 degrees west, we can get 172 true. Plus 8 degrees west, we can get 180 magnetic. So 180 magnetic minus 181 minus 180, we can get the variation, a deviation of 1 degrees west. So next is the formula. Deviation positive negative A over B times C. So the A is 152 or 165 minus 152, we can get the 13 degrees. The B is 181 minus 152, we can get the 29 degrees. And the C is 2 degrees minus 1 degrees, we can get the 1 degree. So 2 west minus because it is decreasing 2 degrees to 1 degrees, so decreasing. When it is increasing, when for example 2 degrees to 3 degrees, we will use positive here. So since it is decreasing, we use negative. So 2 west minus open parenthesis 13 over 29 times 1, we can get the answer of 0.448275821 here. So 2 west minus 0.448275821, we can get the deviation of 1.5 west. So that is how you can get the deviation through heading with a gyro error and the variation either. So that's all. Thank you.
So our question is, you swung ship and compared the magnetic compass against the gyro compass to find the deviation. Gyro error is 2 degrees west. The variation is 8 degrees west. Find the deviation on a true heading of 157. So this is our deviation table. And we can see here the GETPMDC. Our true heading is 360. And the PSC and PGC that we got here is 354, the gyro compass, and the compass is 358.5. And the other, we got the other, the 384 and 390.5. And we have the error, which is 2 west, 2 west. Then the variation is 8 west. So to find the true, we subtract the 354 to 2. So we have here the 352. But and the next is the 360 and 358. The difference is 1.5 east. So in 390, the difference between 390.5 is 0.5 west. So to find that deviation, we will use formula, the interpolation. So I will show you the how to get the deviation.
So for interpolation, first we should get the we will subtract first the this two, the 382 minus 352. So the answer is 30. The next one is this, the This is takes 9 minus 352. The answer will be 8. Then, this. The negative 0.5 minus 1.5. So, it will be 2. So, the formula is B over B times C. We're going to substitute the H over 30 times 2 equals 0.26. So times 2, it will be 0.53. Then we will subtract the 0.53 to 1.51. 1.51 minus 0.53 equals 0.967 east. So 0.967 east. This is the answer.
So this is the division that we got after solving it and interpolate it. The division is 0.967 east. So we will proceed to the next. Our true is 0.045, and PSC and PGC that we have here is 0.24 and 0.30.5 and 0.54 and 0.61.5. So we can see here. So the error is 2 west, same, and the variation is 8 west, also the same. So in order to get the true, we have to subtract the 0.24 to 2 west. So we have here the 0.22, and we will apply it also in the 0.54, subtract to 2 west, so we have 0.52. And the magnetic is the difference between 0.5 west and 0.30.5. So 0.5 minus 0.30.5, we have 0.30. Also in the difference between 1.5 west and 0.61.5, so subtract, so we have here the 0.60. So in order to get this 1.267 west, we have to solve it and use the formula again, the interpolation. So I will show you.
So next is first thing to do with interpolation is to subtract this. We're going to subtract this, the 0.22 minus 0.52, then it will be 30. And next is this two, 0.22 minus 0.45, then it will be 0.23. And next is this two, 0.5 plus minus 1.5 plus equals 1. So it will be our C. So the formula is A over B times C. So let's substitute the 0.23 over 0.30 times 1. So is 0.76. Then we're going to add the 0.52076. 0.76 plus 0.5 equals 1.267 plus
So that's the solution on how to get this deviation, the 1.26 west. So we will proceed to our true, which is 0.90. This applied to the succeeding direction. We just change the true compass with the angle that corresponds with the direction. 94 east, 135 for southeast, 180 for south, 225 for southwest, 270 for west, and lastly 315 for northwest. And find the 2 PSE that center the given direction, getting a deviation of 2.1 west for east, 2.1 west for south and east, 0.7733 west for south, 0.383 east for south, west, 1.267 east for west, and a deviation of 2.383 east for northwest.
So today I will show you how to calculate the deviation coefficient for marine magnetic compass. So the first thing you need to remember is that you have to get the value of A, B, C, D, and E. So first, you have to get the value of A. So for you to get the value of A, you need to use this formula. So deviation north plus deviation north by east plus deviation east plus deviation south by east plus deviation south plus deviation south by west plus deviation west plus deviation north by west divided by A. So after you got the formula, you just have to simply substitute all the values that you got from your created deviation table. So this is the values that we got from our deviation table. So we just have to substitute it, and after that you will get this value, which is negative 0.15. Next is to get the value of B. So in order for you to get the value of B, you just simply have to use this formula. Then after you get this formula, just like before, you just have to simply substitute all the values that you got from your deviation table. So after you substitute all the values, you just have to calculate it, and you will get this answer, which is negative 0.34. So now we have to get the value C. So in order for you to get C, you have to use this formula. So deviation north minus deviation south over 4 plus deviation north by east minus deviation south by east over 4 minus deviation south by east minus deviation north by west over 4 times sine 45. So after you have this formula, so just like before, you just have to simply substitute all the values that you got from your deviation table into the formula. So after you substitute all the values, you will get this answer, which is 0.96. So that is for C. Now let's go for D. So in order for you to get the value of D, you just have to simply use this formula. So it's deviation north by east plus deviation south by west over 4 minus deviation south by east plus deviation north by west over 4. So after you get this formula, you just have to simply substitute all the values, some of the values you got from the deviation table. Rather, you have to get these respective values of this from the deviation table. So after that, after you substitute the necessary values, so you will get this answer, which is negative 0.29. Now lastly, we have to get the value of E. So in order for you to get the value of E, you just simply have to use this formula. As you can see, it's kind of similar from the how you get the value of E. So in order for you to get the value of E, so we just have to simply use this formula. So deviation north plus deviation south over 4 minus deviation east plus deviation west over 4. Then after you got this formula, you have to substitute these respective values. So after you substitute it, you just have to calculate it for your calculator, and you will get this number, which is 0.27. That is all.